This is a big day. It's cold out here, and so many of the hurting and so many of the homeless are joining us. Later, after we sign everybody in here and we give them the food, give them the clothes, give them the direct assistance they need right now, we'll be going in having our life skills class. And during part of that life skills class, there'll also be an award being made to Quentin Carter, the man that tried to help save a woman's life, was hit by a car. And he continues to sleep outside and be outside because there is no day center open where he can go to during the day. And even over at night, they put them all out at 5 or 6:30 in the morning. So we're trying to highlight that as well as try to see that Quentin gets a bus ticket back home. Well, that'll all be coming up later. Right now, we're out here with the homeless. They're signing in. They're lining up, getting ready for the class, and also as we get ready to set up different items here to help in the distribution. All this is possible only because of all of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. It's your prayers and gifts that make it possible for us to just get out here among the homeless, out on the streets, and be there when people are hurting. Over here, they're checking bags. They're signing people in over here. They'll be getting clothes lined up, a whole lot more coming your way. So be sure you stay right there with us and check in later.
With me right now is a real hero. This is Quentin Carter, and last Saturday, he basically came to the aid of a woman who had been hit by a hit-and-run driver. She later died, but Quentin himself was hit as he was in the process of really trying to save this woman. He's a homeless man, but that didn't stop him from going to the aid of this woman who was in the middle of the street. Quentin, tell us what happened.
Well, I was walking across the street to go to the store, and there's a woman laying in the middle of the street, just like cars passing and everything. So, you know, I've been down, and that's when I was struck. When I woke up in the hospital, it was messed up.
What made you decide, Quentin? Everybody else was passing by this woman. Mm-hmm. What made you decide to go over?
I just did it. I don't know. I just did it. It was just something that needed to be done, I guess.
You walked over and you had to see a lot of traffic going by.
Yeah, it was
you,
a lot of traffic.
What did you see, sir? What was it like?
I can't remember a lot. Mm-hmm. But I just remember bending down to pick her up and get her out the street, and that's when I got struck. So that's about it.
Were you surprised? Did you see a lot of other people just passing by?
Yeah, there was a lot of people passing by. Nobody stopped at all. They like just went around her. So
this woman was lying in the street. I think it happened like that around Cass Avenue. So this woman's mm-hmm. lying in the middle of the street,
mm-hmm.
Clearly not moving.
Yeah, she wasn't moving at all.
And she's lying in the middle of the street, deceased, and people just driving around her. What was your thoughts when you saw people just driving around this woman who is lying in the streets after having been hit by a car?
I don't know. I wasn't really thinking. I was just trying to get her out the street before something else runs her over or whatever was going on. I didn't even know she got struck by a car. So I was just trying to get out the street. I don't know. I wasn't thinking.
But you were thinking enough to a true act of heroism. I mean, really, that you would go across the street,
mm-hmm.
with traffic,
mm-hmm.
Cars, everything.
Mm-hmm.
You saw this woman,
mm-hmm.
and what it just entered your mind that what I got to do something.
Yeah.
What was going through your mind?
Nothing. I just got to get her out this street. I'm not worried about me. I just got to get her out this street. I can move. She's not moving. I got to get her out this street.
People would say, I mean, you've been homeless for how long?
Since last February.
Yeah, people would say that, hey, someone who's homeless, who has certainly enough issues going on,
mm-hmm.
would stop and take that interest into trying to help another person like that.
Mm-hmm.
Tell people about that, your feeling right now.
I'm feeling nervous right now. You got this camera in my face, but...
Don't be nervous with me.
it was just something that I would hope anybody would do. You know, it's just not looking for anything back from it. You know, it's tragic that the woman passed. I tried to save her, but, you know, can't win them all.
But I know going through what you do every day, and I'm certain that you no doubt will have people who will just ignore you or walk away from you, not help. And, you know, and I'm sure many times you don't get the best of treatment, but that you would just take it upon yourself to help somebody else. That says a lot about you.
Well, I guess. I just did it. I'm just being me, I guess.
All right. Well, look, you're going to get a resolution now.
Okay.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And hopefully everything turns around for your life, too.
I hope so, myself.
Alderman Joe Vaccaro is introducing, I think, this resolution. Quentin, as you heard, has been homeless for some months. He was hit trying to help the woman who was hit and killed. He was hit and seriously wounded by a second car that came along and struck him. Well, as you listen.
So, I thought, well, you know, here's a guy with a college degree in business management. He can't find a job. And it's really going to get into me because I hear friends and people say, hey, there's plenty of jobs, go get them. I ask anybody in this room, throw your wallet away, throw your identity away. Go apply for a job, tell me you don't have a phone or a house. They're not going to ask. So how do you call you? So as much as anything, I do want to bring attention to the homeless issue. And to the problems that we have, we can't just keep ignoring the homeless people. We can't say, well, they don't have a job. Because it's just not that simple when you don't have the identity. But here's a guy with a college degree in business management, can't find a job. So, along with Larry Rice, who's right here, they actually got him transportation back to his family in Louisiana. And so it really bothers me that we're not doing what I believe is enough here. I know we talk about the people that are in the workhouse. We talk about different people. When we leave out of City Hall, we step over these homeless people and say, well, yeah, I got a house. I don't know. It's really been bothering me, and a lot of people think that I've lost my mind, that I'm trying to do more for the homeless people. And believe me, I'm very sincere in wanting to do something. And I can tell you, 2 years ago, I may not have had that same attitude, but getting to meet some of these people, finding guys that are living in their cars, were writing vagrants tickets to these guys like crazy. Some of them having as many as 20 or 30 tickets for vagrancy. Try to go get a job. Try to find a job with no ID. If they do have any ID, they're going to run you if you have a bunch of vagrancy tickets. Another guy I know, I talked to, he has a job. He works from 3 to 11, so he can't go in the shelter. He has to sleep in his car, and they write him tickets because he doesn't earn enough money to live anywhere else but his car. So I'm going to get off my soapbox because I'll be here forever. But I do want to honor Quentin. And Larry Rice, and I'm going to put Elliot Davis in the mix, although he's camera shy himself, that he's done a lot to bring the attention. So this resolution is honoring Quentin for his heroism. He doesn't feel he's a hero. As a young lady, she died. He risked his own life to drag her, along with a friend of his, to drag her out of the street. Unfortunately, he got hit by a hit-and-run driver also. There's two stories I've heard. One is he was trying to get her out of the street prior to her being hit by a car because she was also homeless and had given up on life. And so she was basically going to lay in the street to commit suicide. That's one of the stories I've heard. But, you know, either way, here's a guy that goes out, tries to get somebody. So in my heart, he's a hero. And I'm presenting him with this resolution. I know it's not in bank. I wish everybody would stand up, at least recognize the heroism in him. Quentin, I know your camera's shy, but if you want to come up and say a couple words. So what we're going to do, I think what we're going to do is I'm going to let Lewis go say something, I'm going to have Larry Rice say something. And if Elliot wasn't so camera shy, wherever you're at, I would love to have you just come up here. Yeah, see, he's got a camera. He likes to chase us around with his cameras. He don't like when we do that. Anyway, I'm going to step aside. I'll get off my soapbox. Any further discussion? Alderman from the 12th.
Thank you, Mr. President, members of the board. If it's not inappropriate this time, I would ask that the resolution be embanked.
Been moved by Alderman from 12th, entertain a second. Seconded by Alderman from the 27th and the 26th. Any further discussion? All in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Madam Clerk, please create another copy of this resolution and bank. Any further discussion? I just also want to thank Quentin for, you know, the selflessness to go out in the middle of the street and to get hit to try to save someone else's life. You never know who has it in them to step out and put themselves in danger to help someone else. You have shown by your selfless acts that you have that within you. We're all are gonna be made better because of it. It gives me great honor to see that your story today is being committed to the permanent records of our city. So 100, 200 years from now, when they research the records of the city of St. Louis, they will see Quentin D. Carter Jr.'s name in there, and they'll be able to read about your story and read about how you put yourself in danger to help someone else. Let's give Quentin a big round of applause. Thank you.
I was shocked when our first responders told us that after Quentin got hit, went to the hospital, in critical condition, he's released to the streets. We've been working with him every day as he sleeps outside. We got him a bus ticket. He's not able to leave tomorrow morning because he has to go back in for surgery Tuesday. And my prayer is that we can find him a hotel room, because after he comes out of surgery, I don't want to see him back out there. And also that we can get 1411 Locust open again soon during the day so he wouldn't have to be out there, and others like him. Again, thank you for doing this today. It's meant the world to Quentin and the homeless people. God bless you.
No, I'm going to get off my soapbox and wrap it up. Quentin's going to come up. I'm going to hand this to him. He's getting ready to walk off. But anyway, God bless you all. Thank you for putting up with me in my brief soapbox minute. And Quentin, this is for you. Anyway, God bless you.
How can people help him who heard his story, heard his heroism? What can people do to help?
We're trying to get Quentin in a motel room because he's going in for surgery. And so I'm trying to raise the money in the midst of all these other needs. And if people market for Quentin Carter, then we'll be able to do that. And then, of course, we're getting him a bus ticket back to Louisiana so he can be with his family. And again, it's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166, or NLECSTL.org.
So you're saying since the accident, he was back out on the streets?
Definitely. That's what shocked me so much. That's where,
not accidents, since his act of heroism.
No, he is. He, no, yes, after his
act of heroism. After heroism. He tried to save the woman,
yes.
After he got hit himself by a car, and obviously was in very bad shape, he was back out on
Saturday night, Ray Redlick and our first responders found him outside the bus station, sleeping out on the street. Ray contacted me because he knows I go out on Sunday mornings before I go to church, and I saw Quentin there, and we've been working with him every day. He's been living outside because there's no day center, and that's why we're trying to get 1411 Locust open back up. He didn't want to go to a pop-up shelter. We'd have to be out at 5 in the morning because he can't move around hardly.
So again, how can people help this hero?
They can send a gift, mark it for Quentin Carter in the lower left-hand corner of their check, and send it to New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Call us at 314-421-3020. They can connect. They go out. They can visit them. But let's get them in a motel room. That's what we got to do, particularly after he goes back to surgery on Tuesday.
Thank you, Larry. Larry Rice, New Life Evangelistic Center. Okay, the aldermen are dealing with another resolution, but obviously a very eventful day that you've heard Quentin Carter. Essentially, the young man who tried to save a woman who had been hit by a car. Unfortunately, that woman passed away. That woman passed away. And Quentin was seriously hurt. He is still homeless. And so Larry Rice, New Life Evangelistic Center, trying to help him with a place to stay. And that's where things are right now. Anyway, a very busy day here at the St. Louis Board of Aldermen.
Well, they're gathering up to close out here. And what does it mean to you that all this help comes out?
It's great. It's a great thing that you guys come out here and help out and show that you guys have lots of love for the homeless. And
well, you know, we're trying to get 1411 Locust to open back up soon. Why do you feel that's important?
Because that would help get people off the streets and out of the cold, and give them a warm place and food in their stomach at night.
There are a lot of people out on the streets, not only in St. Louis. We also see them in Springfield, where we have the largest daytime walk-in facility in southwest Missouri, northwestern Arkansas. A lot of homeless people all over in there.
Yes, there is a lot.
How did you end up homeless?
I lost my job.
Did you really? And it's a whole different world, isn't it?
Yes, it's a first-time experience.
Wow. What helps you to keep going day after day?
It's God's love.
Yeah, all right. It's God's love, isn't it? That's
yep.
What's going to make the difference. Amen. I'm out here helping the folks, and it is God's love. People that are out here getting clothes. Anybody need a bag? Put your clothes in. All right. They're out here, and we get them some bags here. They're picking up some clothes. All right. Well, would you like a bag?
Yeah.
All right. Well, again, we thank God for those, and that bring the clothes, and we certainly need more men's clothes. 2428 Woodson Road, you can bring them in. 806 North Jefferson in Springfield also. 2428 Woodson in Overland, and make it possible for us to be able to help so many that are hurting, so many that are homeless. And again, I thank God for all these clothes that are being brought. Particularly need men's clothes at this time. A lot of men out on the streets that need help. Let's see if we can put that over here, gentlemen. He's got some stuff here. All righty, great. Yes, so we'll try to get it. We thank God for the shoes. Here's shoes. All right, here's a bag for you. Here you are.
Well, this just okay. Somebody to have. So.
Well, we thank the Lord for everybody that's been out here helping. Here, you can put some more up here if you'd like, Benjamin.
All right.
So you can put it right here. So, Benjamin, what's it meant? You're in our training program. What's that meant to you?
Sir, it means everything to me, sir. Yes, sir.
You were out on the streets before.
Yeah, it's definitely tough out there. So, you know, it's good to help people out who really need it.
Right. So does it make you feel good helping other people?
Of course. Always.
Looks like there are a lot of them out here, and they're sure going through the clothes, aren't they?
Oh, yeah. They love it.
Right. You got sandwiches out there. Are you bringing those too?
Yep, we got two kinds this time.
All right.
Bologna, peanut butter, jelly.
All right. They're all up here. The sandwiches are. And how are you today? You ready to help the homeless today?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yes.
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, this is Angela, and Angela also works at one of our safe houses. And here's some bags if people want a bag, Angela. Okay. So you can give them a bag if they need one.
Okay.
Right? And we thank God for all of you that are helping to make all this possible here. And again, as I mentioned, we're not only doing this here in St. Louis, but also in Springfield, Missouri.
My name is Pastor Chris Aaron Rice, and I'm here at the Veterans Coming Home Center, a division of New Life Evangelistic Center. And we are here with Gerald.
Yes, sir.
Tell us a little bit about how did this happen? How are you on crutches, and how did that even begin to happen?
I was going westbound, another car was going eastbound, and another car was going westbound, and they collided about the same time, and the individual happened to be intoxicated or under the influence of something, but so therefore.
You started your year out this way? You said that happened January 1st?
Yes, sir.
And was it in the evening? Could they not see very well, or was it pretty much in the day?
Yeah, it was almost morning.
In the morning. Yeah. Okay. So how does this impact your life now? You're living on the streets. Is it harder to move around?
Definitely. Yeah.
And you need to get to jobs. You need to get to places you need to go.
I need to get to doctor's appointments. There are several important things in life that I have to be getting done right now.
And there are so many obstacles for homeless individuals to begin with that when a disability happens or an injury happens like this, it makes it so much harder, right?
Correct.
The only reason we're able to help him is because of people like you who are seeing the need and deciding, I'm going to reach in and help out. We have bus passes for you, and where are you going to go today with those bus passes?
I probably will go over to Connecting Grounds if they're open, check it out for a while, and then I was blessed for a week. They gave me a week's stay over on the paid side of a place, one of the places around town. Mm-hmm. I forgot the name of it, but...
Wonderful. So you've got a place to stay, but you still need transportation. You still need help to get around, and bus passes are really the only way to do that. Isn't that right?
That is absolutely correct.
All right. Well, here are a couple of bus passes, and we just want to say that, you know, this is a safe place for you that you can come and receive services. So thank you so much, and you have a good day.
Yeah, I appreciate everything you guys have done for me.
All right. Thank you. Tell me, what's your name?
Eric.
Eric, why are bus passes so important to you?
Well, if you ain't got any money, you need to get around. So it's better than walking. Mm-hmm. It helps out. You got to go to the south side of town.
Yeah, why do you need to go to the south side of town?
Business, jobs, you know.
Social Security Administration's down there.
Yeah, absolutely.
If somebody steals your ID, you can't get a job. You can't do anything, really, if you don't have an ID. And so you got to apply for a new ID, and the only place is all the way on the other side of town.
You have to have it.
Yeah, and all of the other businesses, really all of the money is on the south side of Springfield. So you have to travel there if you want to find a job that can help you break the cycle of homelessness. But transportation's a huge obstacle, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
And when it's cold, it's even more hard to get around without bus passes.
Absolutely.
So, Eric, we're going to be able to help you out because of people who are donating to New Life. And this is so important in the lives of those who are experiencing homelessness.
Thank you, Pastor. Appreciate it.
Thank you. And we're glad that you're here and we're able to help you because of people like our viewers who are watching this and saying, we want to help those who are in need. So thank you. Have a good day. Rick, how are you doing?
I'm barely surviving.
Barely surviving.
Same story. You know?
Yeah. How do bus passes impact you?
You can tell on stuff, you know, put it on the back of the bus pass, all that good stuff. But, you know, basically it gets you off of the streets, stuff like that.
Helps you to get around to the places that you need to go. And without bus passes, you really can't do that, right?
Yeah, without bus passes, you really can't do that.
And transportation is very, very important. It's a huge obstacle.
Yes, it is. Extremely. It's very important.
Yeah, we're going to help you out with a couple bus passes today. And this, again, it's only because of people who are seeing the need. Huh?
Put some boater stuff on.
Sure, do what you need to, okay?
Okay.
You have a good day, all right, Rick?
All right, thank you.
How are you doing today?
I'm okay.
You're okay?
Yeah.
How would bus passes make your day even better?
Well, in wintertime, you know, by the time I get here, I catch a cold. You know, you get sick because of the weather. Bus passes will actually keep me from getting sick.
Yeah, they help because transportation, you get around a lot better. The buses are a lot warmer than 30, 25 degree weather.
And if I'm walking here a mile down the road, it could start raining or freezing rain, and I'm wet. You know, I'm soaking wet, and I've got a cold, so.
Yeah. The emergency emergency shelters open at 32 degrees or below, but you can get hypothermia at a lot warmer than that if you're wet and it's windy or a little chilly.
And you still have to get there.
You still have to get there, so you got to walk in the rain, the snow, the sleet, the hail.
Whatever weather throws at you.
Yeah, and so bus passes like this make a huge impact in the lives of those who are experiencing homelessness. They keep you from getting sick. They keep you moving, keep you warm. There are a lot of reasons why people need bus passes. So.
Definitely.
Well, thank you so much for talking with us today, and God bless you.
God bless you.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well, thank you. I hope this is the beginning of my acting career of the big screen. But anyway, yeah, I need the bus passes because I do ride bicycles, but I have to go out to the Missouri Career Center out on Sunshine, and that's a pretty good ride for a bicyclist.
Right, and you got all your stuff with you as well.
And I haul all my things.
And so that's really hard just to do on a bike.
Yeah, just to get around on a bicycle. Mm-hmm. And yes, I appreciate them.
Yeah, bus passes make a huge impact for those who are experiencing homelessness, yeah. Isn't that right?
Yes, sir, it does.
And without them, you can get sick a lot easily, or a lot more easy. You can, it's just hard
just
to survive.
Finding a place to sleep at night is kind of a job, you know. Mm-hmm. Can't just sleep anywhere anymore. I mean, they're cracking down on us. I got woke up by the police the other night, man, and said, well, you got to move. Okay, I had to get up and I had to go move and go find another spot. Mm-hmm. You know.
And that adds to the anxiety and to the depression and stress, right?
Well, the stress part, I don't get depressed easily. I'm fairly well balanced, I hope, you know. But it's not easy, man. This is not easy.
Right. And you want to get off the streets.
I pray God for a job, a life, you know, place to live. Mm-hmm.
Well, we are trying to create a safe place for you to come throughout the day. Okay. Yeah. But it's so important. Yeah, it's so important that we have the ability to provide transportation for the individuals who are here. And so thank you so much for talking with us. And we're going to help you out with some bus passes. And God bless you, okay?
Yes, he will. I'm sure he will.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Thank you so much for listening to those who are really struggling with transportation. It's really hard without bus passes to get around and to do things. So thank you and God bless.
Struggle being homeless?
Yeah.
What kind of struggle?
Basically just trying to stay healthy, you know, sheltered, you know.
Yeah, what do you do if you get the flu or something?
Yeah, you have to go to the doctor, of course. Yeah. So
there just isn't any day shelters, it looks like, anywhere around.
Yeah, there's no day shelters.
Let's go around. We're trying to get to the 1411 Locust open back up.
Yeah.
Thank God we have the one in Springfield that's helping a lot of people there, but we got to get something open up here in St. Louis, don't we?
Yeah, well, I stay in the Peter and Paul shelter right now. So
stay at night there?
Yeah, so at least I'm in off the streets at night.
Well,
so
thank the Lord. During the day, though, it's pretty tough.
Yeah, like I said, I just, you know, as soon as I get back employed, you know, and...
Well, we're trying to get a day shelter open at 1411 Locust. We're out circulating petitions. We ask you to please pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center and help us right now as we desire to help those that are in need so that we can get it open. If you'd like to help circulate petitions, we'd love to hear from you. Also, we have legislation before the St. Louis Board of Aldermen trying to move it forward there so that we can go ahead and make the repairs. That's what it is. Neighbors don't want the homeless in their neighborhood, and that's what we've been counting is a lot of bigotry. We were willing to make any and every repair that we could. They just don't want them there, so it's tragic, though, because people have to have somewhere to go, and anybody can end up homeless at any time, can't they?
Yes, sir.
At any time. Sir. And so that's why we not only try to help them by night, but also by day. And again, we want to get open back up here in St. Louis. We can have our life skills class there. We have them presently in room 208 on Friday mornings at St. Louis City Hall. But the need is just so great all the time. And again, I thank God that we're able to help out in Springfield for the day shelter, but we now also need to get open in St. Louis.